Today we are burying a time capsule celebrating LGBT life in 2007. I think Gaydios is quite a sort of landmark project in a way. It's the first FM radio station for lesbian, gay, bisexual, trans Manchester. And so the February broadcast was timed at the same time as LGBT History Month. And we thought, you know, whilst we're looking back and celebrating our LGBT past, we're also making history at the same time. And this is our little contribution to sum up what it means to be lesbian, gay, bisexual, or trans in 2007.
In 2007, to be gay, I would say it means everything. And it means nothing as well. It's everything because it's part of what I am and it's nice to be able to express yourself, but it's nothing because it's only a small part of what you are, and I think more and more people are beginning to realise that it is only a small part of people, and we're seeing people as people and not labelling them anymore.
It's obviously a lot more accepted now, so much so that I have not got a problem walking down the street with Anthony arm in arm, this, that and the other, and going out and just being myself.
Expression wise, it's more open now. I think it's more more acceptable compared to when I first came out.
Okay. And in our time capsule, we're going to start off with a couple of gay men's safer sex packs. Two lubes, two condoms in there. Hopefully in 100 years we won't be having them. But these expire on the 31st of July 2009. We've also got some flyers from our second coming. There you go. Hopefully remind people of why we were here at the time. We've then got, oh, it's getting excited. A load of photographs of the team from Gaydio 2007, including the group photo, and many others. Fortunately, we've all got our clothes on. We've got a number of discs. Gaydio's first hour of the second broadcast. A lovely disc. We've then got nicely wrapped in cling film. We've also got Billy Grant and Alice Gaydio Show, February 2007. MP3 format, you won't know what that is in 100 years. Are they you naked?
No, that's the wedding.
Oh, that's the wedding.
Civil partnership. The whole hour of the Brian Day Show.
That we did, all the Brian Day Show.
In memoriam.
A copy of Hot Village. In fact, which we're in, on page there. Just handed from the side, one I prepared earlier. We've got the red ribbon, which is a symbol of HIV support in the UK, in the world in fact, and a pink Union Jack. Somebody would spare no expense in clothes over for that one. Right, there you go.
It's funny, because I hear a lot of people saying, there's so much more acceptance nowadays, and of course there is, but I don't think it's that widespread, to be honest. I mean, yeah, you know, people can walk down Canal Street with their boyfriend or girlfriend or whatever, but you know, you couldn't do that down Deansgate very easily, I don't think. So I think there's still sort of a long way to go in terms of proper acceptance for LGBT persons in society.
We've got Out Northwest, 25th anniversary edition, that's 25 years of living with HIV. That came out in December 2006. I don't know why we've got this one. What's this one? Oh, more flyers. July 2006. Is this the one that's got Ian and Toby in? Somewhere? Oh. Sorry, look.
Okay, for me, being gay in 2007, it's about acceptance. You know, we've come a long way in the last few years, and I think over the next few years things will move on, and yeah, we'll become fully integrated in society, and we'll be fully accepted.
A big change from 30 years ago, or even 40 years ago, or even 20 years ago, when I was first out, I wasn't out, it was illegal. So I'd have been sent to prison, and if I'd been caught, that was, but I wasn't. I had electric therapy, which was supposed to cure me, in hospital. My doctor sent me to the hospital, and they wired me up to the mains, in the thought that this treatment would cure me from being gay.
In 2007, you're able to express yourself a lot more than, say, 30 years ago, so it's quite important and significant in that way. I mean, 30, 40 years ago, you wouldn't be able to do something open like this and feel proud of it.
And for me, I think it's a simple sort of thing. It's being able to express myself as a gay man in Manchester and everywhere else I go. Whereas when I first came out, I wasn't actually able to do that. But the gay scene was still at that stage very much underground.
When we did the August broadcast around Pride in 2006, we did 2 weeks and, you know, thought that was quite a massive achievement. In February we didn't have the festival to pin it all around, and we did a month which, you know, demonstrated to me and I think to a lot of other people that, you know, there really is demand for a full-time LGBT community station in Manchester. So I think the next step is to come back in August for a month again. And you know, achieve bigger and better things.
Gaydio 87.7 with AXM Bar.